exhilarating sports talk coming up next on The Doug Stewart Show in about 2 minutes. Stay tuned. We're about to have some fun. That's right. Sports talk, guy talk, right here on The Doug Stewart Show. Show coming up in about a minute and a half. Hold on. The No Puppet Zone. That's right. No puppetry around here. The Doug Stewart Show coming up in about 1 minute. The realest, trealest, most unfiltered sports and guy talk show in America. The Doug Stewart Show, coming up in about 30 seconds. Yes!
Play this record as frequently as possible.
The Doug Stewart Show
is the best in the world as far as I'm concerned.
This is sports talk for the people. The Doug Stewart Show. It's like the tail wagging the dog. They create the narrative. Don't believe it. Don't fall for the banana in the tailpipe. Or are you not entertained?
This is sports talk with hot sauce.
Texas Pete hot sauce. The Doug Stewart Show.
Yeah!
What's happening? Welcome to the Doug Stewart Show. And this is a Woman Wednesday. And oh boy, we got a lot of great things planned for you today, as we do every single day. Shots out and good morning to all of the Stewies. Yes. Yes. Good morning to all of the Stewies, man. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Doug Stewart Show. We got a big day planned for you, not just on this show, but a couple other shows as well coming on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. But before we get into all of that, Cassidy, bring that beat back for your boy one more time. Bring it back. Bring it back. Ooh, I feel good when I hear that. Scratch beat. This is the Doug Stewart Show, Woman Wednesday. And, man, got a lot planned for you, man. Thank you. Thank you once again for tuning in. Happy Wednesday to you. Happy Woman Wednesday to you. All right, so what we going to do today, man, is kind of flip it. I mean, for our purposes around here, man, we're going to pay homage to all of the mothers today on a Woman's Wednesday. You know, Mother's Day is this Sunday. And so, I mean, we make our own rules around here. So for us, we are paying homage to all of the mothers, and kind of in a way as well, paying tribute to the great Afeni Shakur, the lady that birthed the great Tupac Shakur. She passed away on yesterday. So today, Woman Wednesday, we're also paying homage to mothers today. I'll tell you more about that. All right, so if you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, we get new listeners every single day. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, a couple of things you need to do. You need to go to Stewart Media and Entertainment as well as the Doug Stewart Show on Spreaker. That's Spreaker.com. If you're not listening on Spreaker, go to Spreaker.com. Once again, that's speaker with an aura. Spreaker.com. Search and find Stewart Media and Entertainment and the Doug Stewart Show. Hit the follow button. That's very important that you hit the follow button. What that means is whenever this show goes live or whenever any other show goes live from the network, you will get an alert and you set it up. It takes like 2 minutes. I promise you. It takes like 2 minutes. You set it up and you can get an alert through Facebook, through Twitter, or just an email. So that's very important you hit that follow button. Make sure you do that, all right? That's step number one. Step number two is you'll see a little chat bubble thingy. You need to click on the little chat bubble and jump into the best chat room in the world. That's right, you heard me. I didn't say in Georgia or Atlanta where we're based at. I didn't say in the Southeast or America. I said the best chat room in the world! Yes! I call it the Fantasy Island of Sports and Guy Chat. And its inhabitants, the people in that chat room are the Stewies. So jump in there and post your thoughts on everything that we talk about throughout the show. And I read a lot of that stuff, man. It kind of adds to the show. I call the Stewies my co-hosts, my wingmen. And once again, the best chat room in America. You'll see that's what makes this show the most interactive sports guy talk show in general in the world. All right? All right, so let's see. How do I want to roll this out? We have so much stuff going on. How about this? Let's talk about the shows that are coming up today on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network immediately following me. More X-Squad shows coming up today. The Kicking It With Kesey show comes up at 12 noon Eastern Time, immediately following the Doug Stewart Show. That's why it's so important you need to hit the follow button so you'll know that. But I'm telling you right now, at 12 noon today, the Kicking It With Kesey show, starring my man Kesey, and the title of today's episode is Stop Effing Posting So Much. Yeah. And what Kesey's talking about in this episode is about how social media is just too social today. And how these kids, they just post their whole lives on social media. We talked about this a couple of days ago, but my man Kesey is going to really delve into it in depth. So today, the Kicking It With Kesey show, 12 noon, stop effing posting so much, man. So stay tuned for that. And then in about an hour later, the Grizz, my man Rashad Grizzmore, South Central's finest, coming to you from L.A. He's talking sports, man. He's talking Laremy Tunsil, the basketball stories out there, the NBA, coaching vacancies in the NBA. The Grizz doing it only the way that he can. The Grizz at 1 p.m. Eastern Time today, right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. And then following the Grizz at 2 p.m. Eastern Time today, the Bottom to the Top show. That's right. The Bottom to the Top show is back with my man Vern from Jersey and John Fisher cooking with the microwave. As they welcome back John Fisher from a little trip to the White House. I'm laughing so I don't cry, bruh. So, yeah, they're going to be talking about John Fisher and his little two-week hiatus, man. He's back. It's going to be crazy. Not only is John Fisher and Vern hosting the show, the Bottom to the Top show, but they also have Mandaleon, Spicy from Spicy Connections. Yes, Spicy. And Grandma Eunice. If you've never heard Grandma Eunice, she reminds me so much of my grandmama. But Grandmama Eunice on their show today, man, is just crazy, crazy, crazy fun. So make sure you stay tuned to the Bottom to the Top show today at 2 p.m. Eastern Time right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. As far as us today on this show, the normal fun and shenanigans. We'll talk about the NBA playoffs, Warriors and Heat. Cris Bosh is really, really tripping. The NBA still apologizing for bad calls. The NFL does good in the hood. A player from the NFL does good in the hood. And it's only a matter of time, man. It's only a matter of time things change at SMU. I'll tell you more about that later. We also have a great top five topic for you today on this Woman Wednesday. I mentioned how the great Afeni Shakur passed away on yesterday at the age of 69, Tupac Shakur's mama. So today, man, we're celebrating Mother's Day a little bit early. I mean, it works perfectly. It's Wednesday, Women's Wednesday. We gave women their own day on the Doug Stewart Show. I mean, who else is doing that? Nobody. So today, in honor of Tupac and his legendary, iconic song, Dear Mama, we always like to infuse hip-hop and, you know, in the conversation on the show. So today, I'm going to give you the top five hip-hop tracks about mamas. That's what we're going to do today. It ain't a lot of them. There's not a lot of them, so I'm pretty sure you will know most of these, but that's what we'll do today, the top five hip-hop tracks about mama. Happy early Mother's Day to all the mothers out there listening to the Doug Stewart Show. You may think that it's all guys that listen to this show and to this network. You would be so wrong. Analytics show that we have a huge listener base of women that listen to the show, and I guess because, you know, they like to find out what the dude's talking about. You know, and not just sports, but entertainment, guy talk or whatever. And then also a lot of times, man, we like to get a perspective from women. So we do have a lot of women that listen to the show, man. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Doug Stewart Show. And if you listen to for more than a day or so, you know how we get down around here. We keeps it real. We have the best time. We have the most fun online, terrestrial radio, it doesn't matter, right here on the Doug Stewart Show and the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. I need the mamas to pray for us, for America in general, because it's a very good chance that Donald Trump might be the president of these here United States of America. That's right, you heard me. You know what this thing is, man, this Donald Trump thing? And I'm not going to stay on this, man. I mean, we had a show a couple of months ago where I went like 30 minutes just absolutely having a conniption about Donald Trump. So Donald Trump overwhelmingly won the state of Indiana yesterday in these primaries. And it's a foregone conclusion. He's going to be the Republican nominee for the president, for the presidency. You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of, like, you ever been in a car accident, knock on wood, that you haven't, hopefully. But I'm going to tell you from the perspective of somebody that has been in a couple of car accidents in their life. When you're in a car accident, everything slows down. It's like slow motion. It's like a freaking movie. It's like a scene from a movie. Like everything slows down. And then you crash. Watching this Donald Trump thing play out over the last couple of months, you know, really over like the last year, is like a freaking car crash. Like, I really don't think people are really grasping what's going on in front of us. We are about to elect, probably on record, based on some of the statements that he's made in his life, the most racist, misogynistic, you know, imbecile of a guy that you could ever vote for the president. It's unbelievable. This cat has got a great chance to be the leader of the free world. Oh my gosh! Like, I don't think people really get it. Like, I think this thing started out as a joke. I think the Republicans thought it'd be funny. Yeah, we'll vote for Donald Trump. And then it just snowballed to the point where this cat, where he's actually gonna win! You better get right with God. That's all I got to say. You better get right with God. When we get back, we'll try to get right with the NBA and talk about the action from last night, man. Incredible. Sports talk, guy talk, people talk. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away. We'll be back in 3 minutes. Oh, my gosh.
This is your boy KC.
Kicking it with KC. Show.
And I'm bringing along some of my friends to the SME Network.
Squad. Fill in.
Take over. The break's over.
Houston sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BB Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bbmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bbmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7.
Yeah. I dedicate this song to that one special lady.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. This is a Woman Wednesday. So this didn't make my top five, but this is honorable mention. It's that boy Saigon, If My Mommy. Top five hip-hop tracks about mama.
I wrote about sticking to mommy. Uh-huh. Wrote about licking the Tommy. Yeah. It's time for me to write some shit for my mommy, my mother.
What y'all know about Saigon? Hey, the number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. I'm seeing all of this chat in the chat room. We're going to jump to the basketball here in a second, I promise you. And thank you for joining your boy. And thank you for listening to the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. But I need to read this one chat message in reference to the Donald Trump talk I threw out there last time from a man, RC, in the chat room on Spreaker.com. RC says, I've said it many times here in the chat. If this clown Trump gets elected president, he might get all our asses killed. And he said kilt, K-I-L-T. Yeah, man, Donald Trump gonna get us all killed. And I did say kilt, you know, as in the Scottish dress type thing that them dudes wear. He's going to get us all killed. And I mean, I'm laughing, but this is really a serious, serious matter. It's like the AKAs up in this bitch. It's a serious matter. Like, it's not funny anymore. Okay, you got us. Oh, you funny Republicans. You voted Donald Trump as your nominee for president. Oh, you jokesters. All right, enough is enough. The joke is over, bruh. Republicans. And I'm sure there's some Republicans that are listening to the show right now. Serious talk, man. Serious talk. It's not funny anymore. It is not funny anymore. It's got to the point where it's very, very serious. It's very serious. Now, I don't know what kind of warped sense of humor y'all got in electing Donald Trump as your nominee for president, but All right, it's time to move on. Let's stop it. All right, joke's over. Let's just move on. Let's go ahead and really, you know, elect the president. Stop with the funny business of Donald Trump as your nominee. Please, I beg of you. Don't you understand he's going to get all our asses killed? Do you not understand that? If you're a Republican and you're listening to the sound of my voice, understand this, and I can't say it no more succinct than my man RC said in the chat room. He is going to get all our asses killed. Stop it. Please stop it. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Okay? When he's going back and forth with the leader of North Korea, you know, taking shots at him, saying, you know, all of these little belittling things and trying to, you know, play the dozens with the dude. I can't remember his name. Something Kim. If he does, if when he starts having a little war of words with that dude, then what? I tell you what, he's going to get all our asses killed. Stop playing. Seriously. All right, joke's over. The joke is over. And I'm saying this with a lot of, you know, I'm trying to be humorous about it, but I'm serious as a heart attack, man. The joke is over. At some point, you know, move on. It was funny. I got you. Ha, ha, ha. Donald Trump, our nominee. But, man, it's starting to get serious. And so I beg of you, my Republican brothers out there, I'm begging you, please stop it. The joke is over. You're listening to The Doug Stewart Show. This is A Woman Wednesday. Thank you so much for tuning in. Wow. Wow. All right, let's talk a little bit of sports, man. Last night in the NBA, obviously a couple of playoff action, a couple of games action last night in the NBA playoffs. The Toronto Raptors made a game out of it, man. We're in position to win this game at home, but they do go down to the Miami Heat 102-96. Jonas Valanciunas had 24 points, 22 points also for DeMar DeRozan for the Toronto Raptors, but it wasn't enough as Goran Dragic playing his ass off the last couple of games, man. 26 points last night for him, and Dwayne Wade would clutch plays at the end of the game last night. Gets 24 points, 6 boards as well, and 4 assists as the Miami Heat do win game 1 of their 7-game series in the Eastern Conference Semifinals. Ball award to the Miami Heat. Some of the plays you saw Dwayne Wade make last night at the end of that game. Some of the plays that you saw him make last night at the end of that game is the reason why, you know, Dwayne Wade is one of the best, you know, two guards in the history of the game, because he's always been clutch from day one. Like, I don't remember Dwayne Wade having, a learning curve or whatever when he got to the NBA. Dwayne Wade, from the very first time we seen this guy at Marquette, you know, dominating in the tournament his last year in college, to really his rookie year in the NBA and subsequently winning a couple of NBA championships, man, he is just a great player. I mean, a phenomenal player, man. Has had a lot of injuries over the last couple of years, man, but some of the plays, the scrums on the ground for the basketball last night, for the loose ball, the clutch shots at the end of the game last night, man, just a clutch player, has been a clutch player his entire life, man. I love Flash's game. So they get game 1 in their best of 7-game series. And the other game last night, obviously, the Golden State Warriors come back from way down at the start of the fourth quarter to beat the Portland Trail Blazers 110-99. Ball award to them. They're now 2-0 up on the Portland Trail Blazers in their best of 7 series. And once again, now listen, a lot of y'all think that I throw shade on Steph Curry, you know, because he's all light-skinned and all that. For whatever reason, I don't know why. But that's not the case. And speaking of which, the other light-skinned dude on that team, my man Klay Thompson, man, this is, you know, I'm kind of giving some ode to him in this conversation I'm about to have with y'all. There's been a lot of talk about, you know, how much of an MVP really is Steph Curry, you know? Because as the way I understand the MVP award, and I do need to tell you that Klay Thompson scored 27 points last night, you know, with no Steph Curry on the floor, and they do win. They don't skip a beat at all. But let's be honest, the way I understand the MVP award, not just in the NBA, but the NFL, baseball as well, but more in particular the NBA. Let's talk about the NBA right now. The way I understand it is, how valuable is this person to their team? It's a combination of how good the player is, like in relative terms, is he the best player in the league? But also it is part of the equation. One of the variables is, how valuable are you to your team? All right. Now, I don't want to make a big thing out of this because it's only been a couple of games that they haven't had Steph, and they, you know, haven't skipped the beat once again. But if you take Steph Curry away and Klay Thompson goes for 27, 30 points a night and they continue to win, they don't skip a beat. You know, the question is out there, and this is just what we do. The question is out there, how valuable is Steph? Whereas if you, I don't know, if you talked about LeBron James from the Cleveland Cavaliers. If you take LeBron James away from that team, how many games do they lose? I'd say they probably lose 25 more games. Well, you've taken away Steph Curry, the supposed two-time MVP. They haven't skipped a beat. As a matter of fact, there's a guy on their team that's doing as well, you could argue, than Steph has been doing. Now, Steph is a phenomenal player, and once again, this may sound blasphemous to a lot of y'all. I'm just saying, you take LeBron away from the Cleveland Cavaliers, they aren't the same team. You take Damian Lillard away from the Portland Trail Blazers, they lose 20 more games. I mean, easily, in my opinion. They have some solid pieces, but they lose a ton more games. Golden State, they haven't skipped a beat. I'm just saying. IJS, just something to think about. How valuable are you to your team? If they take you away, how much does it affect the winning and losing of said team, okay? Right now, this is kind of an indictment on Steph. Really, he's a great player. He's phenomenal. I'm not mad he won the MVP. But they've taken him away, and they have not skipped a beat. It's just a head scratcher. It's something interesting to think about. What are your thoughts on that? 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug of the DougStewartShow.com. I think what's lost in all of that conversation, it's just how good Draymond Green is. I mean, he's pretty much the straw that stirs the drink. I mean, he does everything for that team. Everything. Even as far as being the emotional leader of that team. He is the leader of that team. Steph Curry may have won the MVP, probably going to win it 2 years in a row. But Draymond Green is the cat that gets everybody up. He is, and I don't think we give him enough credit. I don't think we give him enough credit. Draymond Green is pretty much Dennis Rodman on steroids. When I say that, he does all the things that Rodman did, maybe not to the level Rodman did it, but on top of that, Rodman wasn't no damn leader. Draymond Green is the vocal leader of that team. He can pass, he can shoot, he can dribble, he plays tough defense. He's the enforcer of that team. Okay? So I don't know, man. I don't know. Very interesting. We'll see how this plays out. Maybe if Steph doesn't come back, they'll lose a couple of games in a row. I doubt it. They got a nice squad from top to bottom. What are your thoughts on that? When we get back from the break, all I'm going to do is read your chat. That's all we're going to do is read your chat. How about that? A Woman Wednesday. We'll also come back with song number 5 on my list of top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama. Happy Mama's Day to all of the mothers out there. Rest in peace to the great Afeni Shakur. Don't go away. We'll be back in 3 minutes. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bbmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bbmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. Doug Stewart here to tell you about my man Smooth at smoothtickets.com. Smooth's got the tickets for everything that you need in the world of sports, concerts, or theater. I don't care what it is. I don't care where it's at in this great land of ours. My man Smooth at smoothtickets.com, he got them tickets. I'm telling you, boxing, baseball, NBA, NFL, country music concerts, hard rock, hip-hop, theater, Broadway, he's got them all. And if he don't have them, there ain't none. I'm telling you, smoothtickets.com. Once again, that's smoothtickets.com or give him a call at 404-374-1150. Once again, that's 404-374-1150. You got to tell him, though, that I sent you. You got to tell them that Doug Stewart sent you. Once again, smoothtickets.com. That's smoothtickets.com. Yeah! Protect yourself at all times. The referee issues that reminder because it's important to a fighter's safety and success. Doug Stewart here to tell you about the team at Strickland Security and remind you that living in the Metro Atlanta area is sometimes like boxing. You've got to protect yourself at all times. There's nothing more important than ensuring the safety of your family and your home. And for business owners, protecting your business is critical because it's your livelihood. Strickland Security can satisfy all of your security needs. The staff at Strickland Security has a combined 55 years of experience protecting people and property. From alarm systems to uniform security guards and everything in between, Strickland Security has an affordable solution for you. To see a list of all of the security services they offer, visit their website at strictlysecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. Again, that's strictlysecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075.
Feel me now, listen, mama loved me, pop left me, Mickey fed me, Annie dressed me, Eric fought me, made me tougher, love you for that my nigga, no matter what bruh, Marcy raised me, and whether right or wrong, streets gave me all I write in a song.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Top 5 hip hop tracks about mama coming in at number 5 from the Blueprint album. My man, Jay-Z, Jigga Man, Mama Loves Me. Happy Mother's Day to all of the mamas out there. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. It is a Woman Wednesday. Getting your thoughts, man, on the Golden State Warriors and how valuable is Steph Curry at the end of the day. And I'm not throwing no shade on Steph Curry, man, and the little diatribe I had in the last segment, but I mean, I'm being honest, I'm being real about this. Like, you took Michael Jordan away from the Chicago Bulls, they don't win 6 championships. As much as I love Scottie Pippen, they don't win 6 championships. It's as simple as that. Because a leader is a cat that you just can't do without, okay? And even though the year after Jordan, or was it the year, after he retired, it was the year that he went and played minor league baseball and all of that, the Bulls made it, I believe, to the semifinals, or it might even have been the Eastern Conference Finals. But they lost in the series to, who was it, to the Knicks, I believe. And I hate to try to remember history like that. But still, they didn't win it. They did not win it. Whereas Jordan, it was a foregone conclusion that they were going to win it. There's a lot of examples like that of players in the NBA today that if you take them away from their squad, from their team, they're just terribly lacking. I mean, maybe you can even make the argument for a cat like John Wall in D.C. For the Wizards. Maybe not the greatest example because they didn't win a ton of games this year. But that phenomenal, that great of a player, that great of a talent, a guy that really does multiple things on the floor, you can make the argument for, man. And the Golden State Warriors, they're just a fine oil machine. They have another player that, in relative terms, you know, He might be just as valuable to that team. We'll find out here in the next couple of weeks if Steph continues to miss games, even though they say Steph is about to come back. They think that he's about to come back. But, yeah, you know, and this is almost like that debate I have with y'all about you know, the great players in the league that play second fiddle to a quote-unquote great player. The best example was Kyrie Irving in Cleveland. I mean, Kyrie got mad game, man. A lot of y'all don't want to admit it. Y'all don't want to give him credit. Kyrie got caught up in a bad situation, in my opinion, in Cleveland. You know, signed that $100-plus million deal. They were about to make the whole, you know, build the whole franchise around him. And then LeBron James just, like, falls right out of the sky to their lap. So it changed everything. But don't get it twisted. Kyrie is nice like that. And so when you're that great of a player, you know, egos become involved. And I know it's killing this dude that he has to acquiesce to LeBron James, but he has to. He has to. So very interesting story, man. Kind of like the same situation maybe Klay Thompson's in. Maybe we don't even know how great Klay Thompson is because, you know, the number one option on that team, they defer to Steph Curry. Maybe if Klay Thompson was on another team, maybe if that trade that they talked about a couple of years ago, that I know that the Golden State Warriors are happy wasn't consummated. Maybe that trade for Klay Thompson to Minnesota for Kevin Love, maybe if that trade goes down, maybe Klay Thompson's leading Minnesota to the playoffs, to the second round of playoffs. Maybe he averages 35 a night. You know, maybe he's going on his second MVP. We don't know. But I'm telling you what, he's playing some basketball, man. Ball award to Klay Thompson. He ain't like his daddy. Now, we've had Michael Thompson on the show here a couple of times on the Doug Stewart Show. We used to have him on the Two Live Shoes all the time. Michael Thompson was a good player, a solid player. I think Michael Thompson was the first pick in the draft when he came out of college. I believe that's the case. I can confirm that in a little while. Stay tuned. Excuse me, but Michael Thompson played for my Lakers, and I remember Michael Thompson. Michael Thompson was, he was a poor man's Draymond Green, and I mean a real poor man's Draymond Green. You know, he doesn't have close to the skill set his little boy got. I mean, Klay Thompson is like that, man, and man, incredible what Golden State is doing right now without Steph Curry, man. Don't forget, at 12 noon today, the Kicking It with Kesey show. Stop effing posting everything, man. Kesey's going to talk about social media and how it's out of control with our youngins. 1 p.m. Eastern Time, the Grizz. He's talking basketball, the latest on Laremy Tunsil. I may get into that a little bit later today as well. Coaching vacancies in the NBA. And then at 2 p.m., the bottom to the top show, my man John Fisher cooking with the microwave, Vern from Jersey. A couple of other guests as well join them, man, as they welcome John Fisher home from a little trip that he had to take. Yeah, so that's at 2 p.m. today right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. From Leon in the chat room on Spreaker.com, Leon says, I think that's a valid point, Doug. Golden State is better than I thought. Take LeBron off the Cavs, the Hawks go to the finals for the second year in a row. Well, you take LeBron off the Cavs, I think they still make it just because of Kyrie Irving. I think they probably, in the other pieces they have, I think they make it, but they're probably a 6 seed. They're probably a 5, 6, or 7 seed if they don't have LeBron James. Let's just be honest about that. So, yeah, I mean, I know I made a point from T-Dub. Rodman is not the talent that Draymond is. No, he's not. As much as I love Rodman, and listen, Draymond is young. He still has a lot of things to do to make it to the level and the iconic status of a Dennis Rodman. You know, he's a young player. But at this rate he's going at right now, you know, another couple of years, man, he's a Hall of Famer. He's a bona fide Hall of Famer with 2-3 more rings, doing the what he does for this team night in and night out. He's a Hall of Famer. And once again, his skill set way surpasses Dennis Rodman. If you're new to basketball, if you're one of them youngins I always talk about, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, and you don't remember when Dennis Rodman played? Dennis Rodman was, I mean, he was a beast on the glass. I have a problem with Dennis Rodman being in the Hall of Fame. Now, whenever I say that, a lot of y'all say, oh, you're crazy. Dennis Rodman is a Hall of Famer. And I guess everything surrounding Rodman, and maybe it does make him a Hall of Famer. He won rings with Detroit and with Chicago. He was maybe the best pound-for-pound rebounder in the history of the game. I get that. Tenacious on the glass. Got under everybody's skin, would help them win games. I get all of that. But Dennis Rodman had no semblance of an offensive game. Zero. Zero. Now, he could get out on a fast break and make a layup. He wouldn't blow a layup, but he didn't have any offensive game at all that I can remember. I mean, he probably could hit a little, you know, 6 or 7 foot bunny or whatever, but I mean, no. Draymond Green, this man shoots threes like a god. This man shoots threes like a god. This man, I have seen this man just in the last couple of games that I can remember bring the ball up from, you know, full court and just streak down the middle of the lane and score on a dunk or a layup. I mean, he can handle the ball. He can do it all, man. I just think because of him being on a team with other great superstars, and they are superstars, and talking about Clay and Steph, that he's overshadowed a little bit. Let's see. More of your chat in the chat room on Spreaker.com. From Uncle Mike, Rodman is in the hall if very good. Rodman is in the hall if very good. No, he's in the Hall of Fame. I mean, but I always talk about how, you know, the Basketball Hall of Fame is just that. It's not the NBA Hall of Fame. So there's a lot of cats in there that I don't think have complete rounded games. Like, they can do everything. I have a higher expectancy for you in Hall of Fames than a lot of the Hall of Fames do, which that's just my little hang up. But Robin's a Hall of Famer, you know. I wouldn't have put him in the Hall of Fame. You know, I just think he was too limited in what he did on the floor in comparison to all the other cats that are in the Hall of Fame that had complete games, that had a complete skill set. That's just me. From Uncle Mike, he's got a third fun in the D-League. Not sure what you're talking about. From Loose Neck, EOD, Clipper Psy, Clay's brother hit the moonshot home run last night. From Miss Mocha, I am Woman Bella. Happy Woman Wednesday to you, Mocha. She says, congratulations to Eddie Murphy and his woman having his ninth child. Eddie Murphy like a damn rabbit out this piece. From RC, Rodman was a great rebound and a very good defender. He was bat-ish crazy, but he's a Hall of Famer in my book. Listen, I'm not saying that it's not a debate, you know. I can find a lot of people that say Rodman was a clear Hall of Famer. I can find a lot of people that agree with me. Not so much. Fantastic player. Rodman is the classic glue guy that every team needs to do all of the dirty work, you know. All of the dirty work in the paint. You need that type of guy. And he was that for the Bulls. He was that for the Pistons. But Draymond Green is that plus a whole lot more is what I'm telling you. If you don't remember Dennis Rodman playing, listen to what I'm telling you. Draymond Green is Dennis Rodman, but way better. Yeah, all around. Yeah, that's just the truth. When we get back from the break, man, let's talk a little bit about Cris Bosh, man. Cris Bosh is tripping. Big time. We'll talk about Cris Bosh, man, and him trying to get back into a uniform. We'll read more of your chat. We'll give you song number 4 on the top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama on this Mother's Day week. Mother's Day is this Sunday. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. A couple other shows coming up today on the network. Make sure you follow Stewart Media and Entertainment and The Doug Stewart Show. All right? Don't go away. This is The Doug Stewart Show.
Hey, what's happening, Stu Nation? This is Vince Wright, the sports governor from Minnesota, and I'm very happy to announce that Sports Done Right, my show, will be making its debut next week on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Make sure you check out not only Sports Done Right, but the rest of my posse, the X-Squad affiliates, as we debut on the SME platform next week. I can't wait to talk to you. We talk all things sports, lifestyle issues, man. We got it all covered here on Sports Done Right. I'm the sports governor. Can't wait to talk to you.
Check out this new track from Lulu featuring Nazi on Lulu216.com. That's Lulu216.com. New track from Lulu.
I'm only 16 in this game and I learn to trust nobody, because that somebody could be the person that always doubts you. Remain humble, just know you're blessed, know your worth, don't let them.
Once again, check out the new tracks from Lulu. Go to Lulu216.com. That's Lulu216.com. New tracks from Lulu. Stuart here to tell you about my man Smooth at SmoothTickets.com. Smooth's got the tickets for everything that you need in the world of sports, concerts, or theater. I don't care what it is. I don't care where it's at in this great land of ours. My man Smooth at SmoothTickets.com, he got them tickets. I'm telling you, boxing, baseball, NBA, NFL, country music concerts, hard rock, hip-hop, theater, Broadway, he's got them all. And if he don't have them, there ain't none. I'm telling you, SmoothTickets.com. Once again, that's SmoothTickets.com, or give him a call at 404-374-1150. Once again, that's 404-374-1150. You gotta tell him, though, that I sent you. You gotta tell them that Doug Stewart sent you. Once again, SmoothTickets.com. That's SmoothTickets.com. Yeah! Protect yourself at all times. The referee issues that reminder because it's important to a fighter's safety and success. Doug Stewart here to tell you about the team at Strickland Security and remind you that living in the Metro Atlanta area is sometimes like boxing. You've got to protect yourself at all times. There's nothing more important than ensuring the safety of your family and your home. And for business owners, protecting your business is critical because it's your livelihood. Strickland Security can satisfy all of your security needs. The staff at Strickland Security has a combined 55 years of experience protecting people and property, from alarm systems to uniform security guards and everything in between. Strickland Security has an affordable solution for you. To see a list of all the security services they offer, visit their website at strictlysecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. Again, that's strictlysecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075.
Yeah, I like to say this one to my favorite girl. Mama, mama, mama. Oh, mama, mama, mama. Yeah.
Yo, she was young and so tender.
Brand Nubian comes in at number 4. Mama. A lot of the people listening to this show right now have no idea who the hell Brand Nubian is. But trust me, Brand Nubian used to bring it.
But sadly, things didn't all work out. So she murked out, pregnant again with my brother wife. My grandmother let her in.
Coming in at number 5 on my list of top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama. Number 5, Jay-Z, Mama Loves Me. And coming in at number 4, the great Brand Nubian with Mama. We might need to give Brand Nubian their own day on Tuesday, man. What's the word, Brand Nubian? What's the word, Brand Nubian? Yes, sir. Hey, 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Have you heard this story about Cris Bosh, man? Cris Bosh is involving the NBA Players Association, the union, to get involved in a dispute between him and his team, the Miami Heat, because he wants to come back and play. Now, Bosh hadn't played in several months because of a reoccurring issue with blood clots, which can kill you. And I've talked about it before, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Lost one of my line brothers, one of my fraternity brothers last year to a blood clot that in effect killed him. And so he's asking the players union to get involved and try to work something out where they all let him go back out there and play. Now, the team doesn't want to play him because, once again, it's blood clots and they can kill you. I don't understand this one. Like, Bosh has allegedly found some doctor. Like, all the other doctors say, no, he shouldn't be out there playing. It's too much of a risk. It's too dangerous. And he and his wife have allegedly found some other doctor who has said that, you know, it's okay. He can come out and play. Bosh's wife, Adrian, who is active on social media and in the Miami community, started a hashtag Bring Bosh Back on Twitter and retweeted several tweets from media members about how the Heat missed Bosh during their first round series with the Charlotte Hornets. Later, Bosh sent out a video on Snapchat of himself shooting in an empty American Airlines arena with the message, still got it. Now, I don't know anything about Cris Bosh's wife, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, and this is a Woman Wednesday. You know, this is a good story to talk about, you know, because it's a Woman's Wednesday. I don't know anything about Cris Bosh's wife, but doesn't that sound a little bit twisted to you? Doesn't that sound a little selfish? Not a little selfish. Doesn't that sound very selfish? That there is some discrepancy on whether if your husband can come back and play basketball, or whether if he comes back and play basketball, that he might, I don't know, die. Is it just me, or is Adrian Bonner out of pocket with this? You know, shouldn't you as a wife, I'm very confused here. Shouldn't you as a wife wish for nothing but the well-being of your husband, the guy that's provided for you an incredible life, I can only imagine, you know, being Cris Bosh's wife. He's probably made $100 million in his lifetime. Shouldn't you want him just to sit down and rest for a minute and relax? Now, it's not even a situation, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. It's not even a situation where he's losing money. They're paying him. And yes, I want to play. I've been injured before playing sports, and you always want to get back out there and play. But that was because I twisted my ankle, or I had a bruised thigh, or maybe I dislocated my shoulder, and I think that it's strong enough to go back in and play. There was no chance that I might, I don't know, die. What am I missing about this story? What am I missing about this story? What are your thoughts on that? What are your thoughts on anything that we've talked about today, man? Cris Bosh just needs to chill, relax. I mean, it's not that serious. You know, you want to win. Once again, you're a team player. Rah, rah, rah. But, bruh, you talking about climbing Jacob's ladder. No. No. Sit your ass down somewhere, man, and relax. Nobody's thinking that you're trying to, you know, fake an injury or anything like that. This is much more grave than that, man. What are your thoughts? That ninja, you are way, way overthinking this one, Doug. His life, his body, that's pretty much the end of it. Yeah, I hear you. How am I overthinking the fact that he could die? This isn't like a rumor out there. We know about blood clots. There's been a lot of very high-profile deaths over the last couple of years dealing with blood clots. This is the second year in a row he's dealt with this. Doctors, many doctors, not just one ninja, many doctors have told him, you know, he's gotten second and third and fourth and fifth opinions that, bruh, you need to sit down and relax. I'm not overthinking this. From Cornelius Small, Bosh has that blood clot commercial on the golf course with the old people. When I saw that, I knew it was serious. Yeah, it's very serious. And once again, ninja, I'm not telling you something that I've just read about. I have experienced this in my life. You know, this blood clot thing, it's very serious. To tell a story to people that are new to the show, this past year, it's been about a year now, one of my line brothers that I pledged with, the tail off my line, William Dixon, went in to have in-and-out knee surgery. It wasn't even like an ACL or nothing like that. It was like just to clean up some cartilage or something like that. And so he went in. You know, they did it in one day. He went home, and he was resting, and he was supposed to keep it elevated or whatever. And I don't know the details of exactly what he was doing for his rehab or not, but 3 days after he had this minor surgery, he died because of a blood clot, okay? And this thing is serious. This is serious. This, my line brother was a cat that went in for a routine surgery. and he got the he injured his knee playing basketball. So you don't injure your knee playing basketball, go in and have a routine surgery, and a couple of days later you die. Okay? So this blood clot thing is serious as hell, man. I just don't get it. And I think his wife is way out of pocket with trying to promote this hashtag, trying to get her husband back out there to play basketball. It's almost like she got an insurance policy on that ninja. Go ahead, honey. Go and play. Even though you've had blood clot issues over the last couple years, hashtag Cris Bosh wants to play. What? Heifer, sit your ass down. What the hell? It's very serious from the dirty mind OK Sigma. Neither the NBA nor his team wants a keen bias situation. Oh, Lynn bias. He meant to say Lynn bias. Neither the NBA nor his team wants a Lynn bias situation. They don't want this dude dying on the court on national TV. And listen, that may not happen. He may come back and he may be fine. But you're exactly right. I'm not going to be the trainer of the Miami Heat. I'm not going to be an official in the NBA that makes decisions on these matters and let Cris Bosh come out there and he freaking die on the middle of the court? Hell no. You got to be kidding me, man. This is a very, very confusing story to me, man, because none of the parts make sense. Why would Bosh want to come back and play so bad? You know, why would he take the guidance from one doctor as opposed to several? You know, why would the NBA consider letting him play? Why does he think the NBA or the Miami Heat would let him play knowing his status? You know, it doesn't make sense to me at all. No, I'm not making too much of this ninja. I'm definitely not doing that. No way. No way, man. You only got one life. It ain't like you got a couple of lives like cats and whatnot. You got one of them. You got one. You want to go out there and play basketball that bad? Well, you're willing to risk that one life that you have? Oh, hell no. Maybe I just got too much common sense. You know, like my boy Charlamagne, he has this show. My homeboy Charlamagne the God has this show on MTV called Not So Common Sense or something like that. See, we from the country. Me and Charlamagne, we from the country. All right? We keep things real simple. Doctor said I got blood clots, and if I go out there and play, I might risk my life. I might die. We straight. We good. Simple as that. I don't know. I don't know. And that wife? Yeah. From Angie, the first lady, right? His wife wants to cash in the life insurance. Dumb as she puts a bunch of little hashtags or whatever. Yeah. I don't want to think that, but that's what I kind of am led to believe based on the circumstances of this story. I don't want to believe. Like, Cris Bosh's wife might be a phenomenal woman. She is very misguided in this, in my opinion. That's my opinion. Yeah. If my wife talk about getting out there to play and she knows my medical condition is that serious, that grave, I'm going to start looking at her sideways. Real sideways. Yeah. Damn it, hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. When we get back, I'll read your chat. There's some NFL news and notes out there as well. Get your thoughts on this Cris Bosh thing. Get your thoughts on the Steph Curry, Klay Thompson MVP talk that we had earlier. Sports talk for the people. Y'all know what it is. Don't go away.
SME, you're not ready for the number one Chief Rocket Jersey Vern doing his recap show on SME. Listen, ain't nobody out here show can go 3 hours nonstop, no commercial interruption, anything like that. The Chief Rocket does a 3 hour show with no breaks. To all you other talk shows, you better up your game and get it right, because the Jersey Vern is about to stomp on you, the number one Chief Rocker. Boom shakalaka, suckers.
Doug Stewart here to tell you about my man Smooth at smoothtickets.com. Smooth's got the tickets for everything that you need in the world of sports, concerts, or theater. I don't care what it is. I don't care where it's at in this great land of ours. My man Smooth at SmoothTickets.com. He got them tickets. I'm telling you. Boxing, baseball, NBA, NFL, country music concerts, hard rock, hip-hop, theater, Broadway. He's got them all. And if he don't have them, there ain't none. I'm telling you. SmoothTickets.com. Once again, that's SmoothTickets.com. Or give him a call at 404-374-1150. Once again, that's 404-374-1150. You got to tell them, though, that I sent you. You got to tell them that Doug Stewart sent you. Once again, SmoothTickets.com. That's SmoothTickets.com. Yeah! Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7. It's hour number 2 of the Doug Stewart Show, baby. Yes, sir. Hour number 2, scratch beat. And this is a Woman Wednesday. Thank you so much for joining your folk. I really do appreciate it. Man, I've been talking all day about the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network and how you should follow and, you know, listen to all the quality programming, man. And, you know, we got the Kicking It with Keeson show coming up today at 12 noon. We got the Grizz coming up at 1 p.m. today, 2 p.m., the Bottom to the Top show. My man John Fisher and the number one Chief Rock of Vern from Jersey. I neglected to talk about Jungle Brother on yesterday. Wow. Yes, yesterday the premiere of the Jungle Brother show. Yeah, so it was Jungle Brother and That Ninja and Thorny Switch came on at the end as well, man. Really, really good, fun show. And here's the thing. You know, we're building a brand here. We're building a network here. That's the whole goal, is to network and help each other's brands and shows grow, okay, by coming together. All right, the X Squad, Rio Cast, and all of these cats. I need you to understand, not all of the shows are going to sound alike. As a matter of fact, I don't want all the shows to sound alike. Like, Jungle Brothers' show sounds totally different from my show. You know, the Bottom to the Top show with Vern and John Fisher, they sound totally different. The Grizz's show sounds totally different. The Barbershop Sports Talk show sounds a lot different. You know, the Barbershop Sports Talk show, them cats are coming from Baltimore, so they got that New York, D.C. type flavor with my man Maestro and Styles, and then the Grizz is from South Central L.A., so he does things, and he does his sports talk radio a little bit different. You know, Vern from Jersey and John Fisher, they're from up top. They're from New York City, Jersey, or wherever the hell Vern is from. And so it sounds different. Don't try to put every show that you hear in a box. You know, listen to it for what it is. And I think the Jungle Brother show was on fire yesterday, man. Shouts out to the Jungle Brother. We're not going to always agree. We're not going to always agree. And I don't want us to all agree, you know, and our sports takes and our thoughts on, on particular stories in sports. But that's what gives it its uniqueness. Shouts out to the Jungle Brother yesterday, him and Ninja. Ninja does a show on the network as well. Shouts out to all of those cats. Thorny Switch, real solid show yesterday. Very taboo type topic. They talked about black quarterbacks and how they feel like that they aren't being treated, you know, fairly in today's NFL still. So very taboo topic, but it was very good stuff, man. So tune into all the shows here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Yes, sir. Next week, we're really going to get cooking, man. Next week, a full slate of new shows from the X-Squad team. My man, Big Smooth from Minnesota. Vern from Jersey. Spicy Connections, Spicy Conversations as well. There's a ton of shows coming to the network. You've been hearing us play these little sounders, these little commercials, promoting the fact that we are rolling out a whole slate of new shows next week, man. Cannot wait. SME out this bitch. Yes. Let me read some of your chat, man. Get some of your thoughts in about 10 minutes. We're going to talk some entertainment. Not a lot of stories out there. We'll talk about some birthdays. Have some fun with that. From FNS Girl. Shouts out to you, FNS Girl. Shouts out to all of the ladies on A Woman Wednesday. Shouts out to all of y'all. She says, clearly, Bosh doesn't care. If he want to risk it, let him. He is probably giving his wife hell at home. That's just like a woman to say something like that. He is probably giving his wife hell at home. That's why she's pushing it. Just like the people that want to jump from the bridge, hell, let them jump. Don't hold up traffic trying to get them down from the bridge. Damn, FNS girl. I hope your husband ain't listening to this show. Because you hardcore as hell. Yeah, I feel you. I mean, I hear where you're coming from. Let's put it like that. I've been on the highway before. I used to live in Marietta. People from Atlanta are familiar with that. And there's a bridge in Marietta that several people have jumped from. And it was a couple of years ago. I don't know why. This is like the jumper's bridge. This is like the go-to bridge for jumpers. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Going up 75 right before you get to Delk Road. You know, I think it might be the overpass, the bridge, Windy Hill. It might be Windy Hill. If you're from Metro Atlanta, you know what I'm talking about. That particular bridge, over the last 10 years, I'm a guess, there's probably been four or five people that have jumped to their death on that bridge. For whatever reason, I don't know. Once again, it's the go-to bridge for jumpers. And I have been caught in traffic many, many years ago. I had been caught in traffic because there was somebody up there on this bridge, you know, threatening that they were going to jump and the police were trying to talk them down. And so, for whatever reason, you have to block 75. I don't understand why. Oh, I guess because if they jump down, there'll be guts on the highway. So, yeah, I get it. But, yeah, FNS girl, I'm kind of with you. When I heard about when you're in the traffic and you find out why, is because somebody up there threatening to jump, you're like, man, go ahead and jump so I can get to my house, man. I had a long day of work. I get it. But this is kind of a different situation, man. From Rail Scott, Cris Bosh's wife is a great American, ass little Wayne. Yeah. From Chico the Alpha, laugh out loud, laughing my ass off, hood ass commercial, love it, Vern. Vern's commercial a little bit earlier. Don't Vern sound like he from Brooklyn, Manhattan, and Staten Island all in one? You know, don't he just sound like the typical New Yorker? You know, this is Vern from Jersey. I got the best sports talk show in America, Jack. Make sure you tune in to the Vern from Jersey show. We bring it to you real, 3 hours. Ain't nobody giving you 3 hours of sports and guy talk like Vern from Jersey. Man, Vern, sit your ass down somewhere with your New York talking ass. Oh, from T-Dub, go ahead and jump Electric Avenue. From Melvin, what's up, Mocha, Vern said, Stu Nation. What's up to you, my man, Melvin? Shouts out to you. Good morning or afternoon based on where you're at. Yeah, and he sounds like he's from Jersey Shores. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. From Leon, everyone's saying let him play, but no one wants to see a player die on the court. Rest in peace, Hank Gathers, Reggie Lewis. Exactly. Exactly. You may not remember the great Hank Gathers played for Loyola Marymount. Had cardiac arrest on the court and died. I mean, very, very morbid scene to see that play out on live TV. Same thing with Reggie Lewis. Played for the Boston Celtics. Same thing. Nah, man, you don't want that on your conscience. Like, if I were the team doctor, the team physician, and I gave him the green light to come back and play, knowing everything that I know, and he died, I don't know if I could ever forgive myself. It's not even that serious. It's a game. Talking about Cris Bosh from Clay, K-I-T-T Davis. Nobody wants to see a dead body while driving back home. Exactly. Talking about the jumping off a bridge thing. From the 47 problem, what up, bro? He said they had to put extra fencing on that top of that bridge so people wouldn't jump from that bridge off of Windy Hill. Exactly. Yeah, you know what I mean, because if you live in Atlanta, you've heard the story many, many times. This one particular bridge, and maybe there's other bridges, and it is the same occurrence, but this one particular bridge, for whatever, it's like there's some type of jumping off a bridge society out there, and they give the best bridges to jump off in your city. And this is the bridge in Georgia, in ATL. Huh? Come on, man. I used to live right off of Delk Road when I first moved to Atlanta. And, yeah, you turn to the little AM station. This is before I was doing radio. You turn to the little AM station and, you know, you get all of the news and they have the breaking news or whatever. And at some point, you know, there's probably a helicopter flying above, so you know something's going on. You can't see all the way up there. Well, yeah, there's a goddamn dude on the bridge threatening to jump off. Bro, just go ahead and do it, man, so we can get home. Clearly, you don't have nothing to live for. Damn, just do us all a favor. But this Bosh thing is totally different. They can do something about this. Bosh doesn't want to die. Or maybe Bosh wants to die. You know, maybe that's part of this equation that I'm just overlooking. Maybe he has some type of freaky, crazy death wish, and he wants to die on the court. No. If I have the ability to stop that, to stop you from doing that, even though you might want to die, you just need to go ahead and just jump off the bridge. I'm not going to let you put on an NBA uniform and have that whole, you know, that disgrace on my hands. If I'm a team trainer or doctor or the NBA, I'm not going to allow you to do that in my league. Hell to the no. No way. I'm not going to let that happen. No. From Grego, it is Windy Hill. And I was always like, push them and scrape them up so we can get out of this traffic. Man, and I know it sounds very, very insensitive, all of these go ahead and jump comments. But you don't live in ATL. You don't understand this traffic, man. You just don't understand it. One of the biggest blessings that occurred from doing radio for over 10 years here in ATL was the fact that I didn't have to jump into rush hour traffic. Like, the earliest our show started was like 11 or noon. It wasn't 11, it's probably noon or 1 p.m. And so I got to go to work, man, for over 10 years, close to 12 years, when it was, you know, there wasn't peak traffic. And when we were done, you know, I actually beat the 5 o'clock traffic, the rush hour traffic with people going home. So I told a story a couple of weeks ago, man, how I had gotten to all types of rage-type incidents on the highways because, as a country boy, I couldn't grasp this traffic thing. Cat pulled out a 40 cal on me one time. I'll never forget it. But, man, you just don't understand. That's why you're hearing all these ATL people like, man, just go ahead and just do it, bruh. Save us all the hassle. Jump! 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 Like, I've been on 75 before, man, and somebody's supposedly about to jump off the bridge, and I've seen a line of people getting out of their cars all in unison, chanting, jump! 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 We're trying to get home! 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 Don't go away. Entertainment coming up next.
Hey you, it's your girl Spicy, host of Spicy Conversations. Join me and my sexy guest as we discuss relationships, sex, and lots of pleasure. A full 2 hours of erotic fun that you don't want to miss. Are you ready to add some spice to your life? Hell yeah you are. And I am ready to please you. Spicy Conversations, SME After Dark.
What is ID life? Well, over the last 18 years, a group of scientists and doctors have been working on the development of a one-of-a-kind nutritional supplement program that takes all the guesswork out of what you need and delivers your truly personalized pharmaceutical-grade nutrition with your name on it directly to your door. Through the integration of thousands of medical and scientific studies, answers you provide to the free assessment and more than 5,470 algorithms that process the data, ID Nutrition recommends what you need, leaves out what you don't, and blocks things known to the system that have possible adverse effects based on the answers you provide. The result is a program that is revolutionizing the health and wellness industry. Welcome to ID Life. For more information, just go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. That's thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. This is Doug Stewart from the Two Live Stews here to tell you about the team at Strickland Security. Let's face it. The Metro Atlanta area is a great place to live, but like most major cities, it has a crime problem. There's nothing more important than ensuring the safety of your family and your home. And for business owners, protecting your business is critical because it's your livelihood. Strickland Security can satisfy all of your security needs. The staff at Strickland Security has a combined 55 years of experience in the business of protecting people and property. From alarm systems to uniform security guards and everything in between, Strickland Security has an affordable solution for you. To see a list of all their security services, visit their website at strickland security.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. That's 800-422-9075. Again, that's strickland security.com.
I want everybody to put their hands together for me. I want to talk about somebody real special tonight.
Coming in at number 3 on my list of top 5 hip hop tracks about mama, Kanye West, Hey Mama.
I know I act a fool, but I promise you I'm going back to school. Appreciate what you allow for me. Just want you to be proud.
I wanna tell the whole world about a friend of mine. This little light of mine, I'm finna let it shine. I'm finna take y'all.
I gotta shoot you straight. I gotta be honest with you, I never heard that track until the day. That was on, I think that was on his first album, Kanye West's first album called Hey Mama. Really, really neat little track, though. Coming in at number 3 on my list of top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama is the great Kanye West with Hey Mama.
Girl, Michael Jackson left the end of club, but didn't give me a curl, and you never put no man over me, and I love you for that, mommy, can't you see? 7 years old, caught you with tears in your eyes, cause a nigga cheating, telling you lies, then I started to cry as we knelt on the...
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show, Woman Wednesday. Happy Mother's Day to all of the mothers out there listening to the show. Mother's Day until this Sunday, but hell, we're doing it today. Why not? We have that liberty on our own network. Why not? We will definitely make it. Give a shout out to the mothers on Friday as well. So make sure you stay tuned to the Doug Stewart Show. So I'm giving you top 5 hip hop tracks about mamas of all time. Number five was Jay-Z, Mama Loves Me. Number four, Brand Nubian, Mama. Number three on my list is Kanye West, Hey Mama. I'll give you number two and number one a little bit later. But now it's time for a little bit of entertainment news here on the Doug Stewart Show. Celebrating. Wow. Which order do I want to do this? I'm going to do it in this order. Celebrating her 86th birthday today, one of the greatest mamas in the history of this country, the great Katherine Jackson, turns 86. The Jackson 5, the mama. You know, Katherine Jackson is a fine example of old school black mamas. You know, back in the day, it was nothing to have 5, 6, 7 kids. You hardly ever see a mother today in 2016 have more than like 2 kids. They got lazy. My father is 5 of them. It was 5 of them. 5 brothers and sisters. Let me make sure I'm right. I'm not forgetting anybody. 3, 4, 6. No, it's actually 6 of them. It's actually 6. Mama Alice, my Aunt Alice, who passed away last year. Gertie, my Aunt Gertie, lives in New York City. My Aunt Mimi lives in Germany, has lived in Germany for the last 40 years, military family. My Uncle Dub, my Uncle Lenny, who's in New York City as well. And my father, that's right, 6 of them. But see, back in the day, they used to have all of those kids so they could tend to the fields. That's the true story. Get your ass out there and tend the fields. At least that's the way it was in South Carolina. I don't know if Catherine had all them damn kids. It's got to be 8 Jacksons. Let's see, it's 5 Jackson 5s. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. It's 5 Jackson 5s. Then there's Rebe. There's LaToya. There's Janet. That's 8. It might be another stray little kid out there, something I don't know about. And I don't know whether her and Joe had all them churn to put them out in the field like they did my parents and my aunts and uncles. Or whether they had all them churn to build one of the greatest singing groups in the history of the world. I just don't know. But happy birthday to the great Katherine Jackson. Speaking of them boatler on a churn that Katherine Jackson had, man, one of her children, the great Jackie Jackson. And I don't know if I should even put great in front of Jackie. But the great Jackie Jackson turned 65 years old today. You know your mama and them old when your ass turned 65. Happy birthday to Jackie Jackson. This ninja's 65. One of the Jacksons is 65 years old. One of the Jackson 5 boys is 65 years old. That makes me look at my own mortality, man, and the fact that I'm getting old as well. Happy birthday to Jackie Jackson. Also celebrating her 41st birthday today, former wife of Russell Simmons, Kamora Lee Simmons, turns 41 years old today. Happy birthday to her. Now, wait a minute. She and Russell had 2 daughters, Ming and Akoi. A Koi or a Ki, some Asian type name, before divorcing. Then she married Tim Lesner, and the couple had a son named Wolf in 2015. Why the hell would you name your damn kid Wolf? Crazy Hollywood people. And she also has a son named Kenzo from a relationship with actor Damon Hansu, you know, the Amistad dude. That's all my wife calls the guy. Whenever that dude, you know, pops up on the TV screen, my wife has no clue what his name is. She just calls him the Amistad dude. That's right, the Amistad dude. So she's had a couple of kids from a couple of different dudes. Now, she was married to Russell Simmons, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. She was married to Russell Simmons a fairly long time ago. I'm going to guess probably maybe 20 years ago, maybe 15 years. So she was very young when she married Russell. I heard Russell like him real, real young. She had to be very young. Kimora Lee Simmons. Obviously, she's black and Asian. I better not say the term that they use for the combination of black and Asian. I don't know if that's politically correct or anything like that. And my brother were here. He would say it that she was, you know, that she was Blackanese. But I'm not going to say that. But if Ryan were here, he would say that. So happy birthday to Kimora Lee Simmons. Fine as white wine. You better believe it. That's a great combination. Victor Oladipo turns 24 years old today. Point guard for the Orlando Magic. And also celebrating his 38th birthday today. I mean, the true definition of a football player. James Harrison, outside linebacker for the Pittsburgh Steelers, turns 38 years old today. Happy birthday to him. You talk about a football player. Like when James Harrison was born, shortly after he was born, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, it became very evident that he was going to be a football player. Maybe the fact that he had a 32-inch neck in seventh grade. Yeah, he probably going to play football. Just like it was very evident to Shaquille O'Neal's parents very early in his life that he's probably going to make a good living playing basketball. James Harrison? The epitome of football player. The epitome of a football player. The great James Harrison, 38 years old today. Happy birthday to him. From Rail Scott, he says, every Puerto Rican chica in North Philly got 8 kids apiece at least. Now see, there you go. My man Rail Scott hailing from Philadelphia, PA. The city of brotherly love, which is one of the biggest lies in the history of the world. From the colonizer Texas Tie, he says, Blackanese might be the race that produces the most beautiful women. Kimora Lee is fine. She is fine as white wine. I mean, you can't take that away from her. Very exotic. That's the word that they give to him. Exotic. From Cornelia Small. Kimora knows the power of PU and has maximized the hustle box game. Yeah, yeah. The Amistad dude, obviously he got some money. He's been in movies for many, many years. He's like the go-to, you know, African-looking dude in movies here in this country. You know Russell Simmons got money hand over fist. I don't know about the second dude that she had a kid for, the listener guy. I don't know about him. I don't know his background. From Andre Elam, Kimora Lee liked the vitamin D. Clearly, she has no issue with vitamin D. Yeah, if you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, vitamin D is kind of like this inside thing for a penis. And nothing wrong with liking penis. Nothing wrong with it. I mean, think where would we be at if there was not penis? You know? From Leon, yes, sir, James Harrison. Back one more year. Yeah, it was just announced a couple of days ago. James Harrison is coming back for another year to play for the Pittsburgh Steelers, man. Dude was almost out of football like 3-4 years ago. Didn't he retire? You know, left Pittsburgh, went to Cincinnati for a couple of years, lost a couple of steps, supposedly. Retired, and Pittsburgh had a need for an outside linebacker. They called him. He's like, yeah, I'll come play for y'all. And he's going to parlay that into another year. Good for him, man. I love that guy. I love the way he plays the game. James Harrison plays the game old school style. The way the game is meant to be played. You know? They're trying to ban players like him. The NFL don't want nothing to do with old school, nasty, you know, running to your ass like a freight train type players like James Harrison. They're trying to get rid of them. But I love them. When you get back from the break, man. The latest on Laremy Tunsil, now the new offensive tackle for the Miami Dolphins, and the whole fiasco from the draft this past weekend. Don't forget, at the top of the 12 p.m. hour today, man, the Kicking It With Kesey show, the Grizz at 1 p.m., and then at 2 p.m. today, right here on Stewart Media and Entertainment, the Bottom to the Top show. My man John Fisher cooking with the microwave, and Vern from, I'm sorry, the number one Chief Rocker, Vern from Jersey, right here on SME. Don't go away. Song number 2, top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama, coming back next. own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BB Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bbmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bbmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. Doug Stewart here to tell you about my man Smooth at smoothtickets.com. Smooth's got the tickets for everything that you need in the world of sports, concerts, or theater. I don't care what it is. I don't care where it's at in this great land of ours. My man Smooth at smoothtickets.com, he got them tickets. I'm telling you, boxing, baseball, NBA, NFL, country music concerts, hard rock, hip-hop, theater, Broadway, he's got them all. And if he don't have them, there ain't none. I'm telling you, smoothtickets.com. Once again, that's smoothtickets.com or give him a call at 404-374-1150. Once again, that's 404-374-1150. You got to tell him, though, that I sent you. You got to tell him that Doug Stewart sent you. Once again, smoothtickets.com. That's smoothtickets.com. Yeah!
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975 and work it out.
SME, this is the number one Chief Rocket Jersey Vern with my partner Jay Fish, Patty Cake, Michael Wade. We're about to surfboard into the SME show, and no other sports show, talk show, any other type of show can do what the Michael Wade and Jersey Vern do, because we are the best at what we do, and we're about to blast you out of there. Peace.
What that gives you, blood?
3 months, man.
What you doing in here anyway? You ought to be home with your mama. How old are you, boy?
13.
Damn. The bastards must be running out of niggas to arrest me.
This goes out to all the families that went through the struggle.
Coming in at number 2 on my list of top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama, the great Ghostface Killer, All That I Got Is You.
Yo, dwelling in the past, flashbacks when I was young. Whoever thought I'd have a baby girl and 3 sons? But going through this difficult stage, I found it hard to believe. While my old earth had so many seeds, but she's her own woman. And due to me, I respect that. I saw life for what it's really worth and took a step back. Family ain't family no more. We used to play ball.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. The Woman Wednesday. Once again, coming in at number 2 on my list of top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama. If not for the obvious number 1 on this category, at least in my opinion, this might have been number 1 in my list, man. Ghostface Killer, once again. All That I Got Is You, former member of Wu-Tang. on my list of top five hip-hop tracks about mama. Yeah, there you have it.
At the foot, two at the head. I didn't like to sleep with John. Johnny peed the bed. 7 o'clock, plucking roaches out the cereal box. Two shared the same spoon. Watch a Saturday cartoon. Sugar water was a thing. Every meal was no frill. In the summer, free lunch held us down like steel. And there were days I had to go to Texas with a note. Stay in Gloria, can I borrow
some? You can say all you want about some of them cats of Wu-Tang, but them boys had skills. Like, I don't know which one was the best one. Have we ever paid homage to Wu-Tang on Tuesday? I know we got a backlog for Tribute Tuesday. Have we ever paid tribute to the great Wu-Tang Clan? If we haven't, we need to do that very, very quickly. Like, there's always this great debate. Like, one of the top five barbershop debates of all times is which one is the best rap off of Wu-Tang. You got Ghostface. You got Raekwon. That dude Inspect the Deck is real nice. I mean, all of them, what is it, 8, 9 members of Wu-Tang Clan? So you also got Method Man. Method Man got his own style. Even some people are throwing ODB, God rest the dead. Now, ODB style, you know, you got this is what you got to know about the Wu when you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. The Wu had all these different styles. They were kind of like, they always mimicked themselves, and this is kind of like a little history lesson for the young people that are listening to the Doug Stewart Show. So the whole premise of Wu-Tang was kind of like they were like this Shaolin, you know, group of kung fu artists that had all these different styles. And if you remember the kung fu movies back in the day, like so-and-so had crane style and so-and-so had kangaroo style, you know. And so their fighting style mimicked a kangaroo, or their fighting style mimicked, you know, a crane or whatever from the Karate Kid movie or whatever. So ODB style, the old Dirty Bastard style, was like the Drunken Monkey. Yes, sir. That's the analogy. The analogy for ODB was kind of like Drunken Monkey style. You ever seen the Shaolin martial artists that had the Drunken Monkey style? They were drunk, but their fighting style was all predicated about their drunkenness. I know it's hard to explain. A lot of you don't know about that type of stuff. But I'm trying to explain something. I'm trying to give you a little bit of edumacation here. All right? So ODP, his style was so abstract and so crazy. It was kind of like he was drunk. But ODB's rhymes, they made a lot of sense. And they had a flow about themselves that was much different than everybody else is out there. Shimmy Shimmy Ya. Rest in peace, ODB. So I don't know. If you had to pick your favorite rapper from the Wu, from Wu-Tang, which one would it be? I really like Ghostface Killer, man, and his style and the way his rhymes flow. Had a great voice, man. And once again, those boys on the Wu-Tang Clan, I don't know if they were high on something, man, but a lot of their rhymes, man, they went very detailed into their rhyme patterns and everything, man. Shouts out to the Wu. Maybe we'll, yeah, this next Tuesday, we're going to give it up for the Wu. Wu-Tang, Wu-Tang. From Bruh McDowell, Master Killer never rhymed. Abstract, lyrical dude, still a beast. From Cornelius Small, Meth is best, or at least most popular. I can agree with that. Meth and Man is, you know, especially with the whole Mary J. Blige track, you know, you know, that they did many, many years ago. You're All I Have, whatever it was called. I can't remember the official title, but y'all know what I'm talking about, the track that he had with Mary J. Blige. That probably gave him most commercial appeal, more crossover appeal. Like, if you ask, you know, citizens of this country, you know, not just black people, like, give me a member off of the Wu-Tang Clan, most people are probably going to say Method Man. But as far as rhyme skills, Ghostface is real nice. Real nice. I'm telling you. Raekwon probably right behind Ghost. And I meant to talk about Laremy Tunsil. We will here in a second, but sometimes we get sidetracked around here. If I had to put him in order, I think I would put Ghostface number one. I would put Raekwon number two. Inspector Deck, maybe Method Man. I guess I would put Method Man probably at number three. And there's another one of them dudes, I can't remember his name right now. The dark-skinned dude has kind of like a big tongue or whatever. I can't remember his name right now, but yeah. I think I would put Ghostface as number one. Let me grab a call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stewart, what's happening?
What's up? Who's this?
T from Huntsville, sir.
T from Huntsville! What's up, T from Huntsville? How you doing, brother?
Hey, man, enjoying the quick 2 hours on radio, like always, sir.
Hey, T.
Yeah, go ahead.
T, that was square work yesterday, man, on the Jungle Brothers show, man. That was square work.
Oh, appreciate it, sir. We try. Trying to get a little better, man. We hope to improve every week and get a little better, man.
Everybody is. What you got for me, T?
Man, I wanted to chime in on that top five because I see you on a collision course with leaving out somebody very important.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, this list is fairly similar. Like you said, not a lot of songs. And I go ahead and full disclosure, I didn't remember the cut about Ghostface, so I had to throw it in here. But at number five, I got Kanye West.
Okay.
At number four, I got Ghostface. Now, I already know you're going to trip, but I got Ghostface at number four.
Okay. All that I got is you. Uh-huh.
At number three, I got Mama Love Me by Jay-Z.
Mama Love Me by Jay-Z. Okay, yeah, I had him at number five. Okay. Who am I missing then?
Number two, you forgot about Guess Who from Goody Mob.
Guess Who? Is that about, and I don't remember the track right now.
I would
ask you to sing it, but you're not an accomplished singer like me, T.
I won't go down that avenue. I don't want to hurt the listeners.
Right. So after the show, I'm going to have to go and research that. Goody Mob, and I'm a Goody Mob fan, so I don't remember right now. What's the name of the track?
Guess Who.
Okay. Doesn't have a mother, you know, an old to mother sounding name, but I believe you. Guess Who? I'll check it out later.
All right, and number one, I mean, I think everybody knows number one is going to be Tupac, Good Mama.
Oh, yeah. I mean, number one on the list of top five hip-hop tracks about mama is the great Tupac Shakur, Dear Mama, especially in honor of the great Afeni Shakur passing away on yesterday. What else you got for me, T?
Man, I just wanted to make sure I hit you with that before you got towards the last break, man. I didn't want you being an Atlanta resident to forget about Goody Mob and go through a whole show. It's just a bad look.
Yeah, it is a bad look, and I kind of feel guilty. I got to go back and listen to it, man. I wish I had it already in the database here. I wish me and Walter had it. I don't think we have it, so I appreciate it, T. Thanks for the call, man.
All right, man. Appreciate it, sir. I'm gone.
There he is. And he's gone. All right. And he's gone. All right, I promise when we get back from the break, I still didn't get to what we're going to do is kind of recap a couple of little stories out there that I didn't get a chance or haven't had a chance to get to throughout today's show. We've done a lot of, you know, just guy talk around here today as opposed to a lot of little stories. They're not really big stories, but I want to kind of give you a follow-up conversation on Laremy Tunsil. I also want to talk a little bit about Florida State. You know, very soon, they're going to have to change their whole style up. I'll tell you more about that when we get back from the break. And we'll wrap up today's show here on the Doug Stewart Show. Yes! My man Kesey coming up in about 15 minutes. The Grizz at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. In the bottom to the top show with my man John Fisher and Vern from Jersey. I'm sorry, the number one chief rocker, Vern from Jersey. That's at 2 p.m. Eastern. All right? So don't go away. We'll wrap up this show coming back. Don't go away. Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. This is your folk Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7.
When I was pregnant in jail, I thought I was going to have a baby and the baby would never be with me, but I was acquitted a month and 3 days before Tupac was born. I was real happy because I had a son.
When I was younger and my mama had beef, 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Go back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman.
All right, y'all know what it is. The Woman Wednesday. You know what it was going to be. Top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama. Coming in at number 1, the great Tupac Shakur, man, with Dear Mama, an ode to his mother, Afeni Shakur, man.
And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blame mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. And who thinking elementary? Hey, I see the penitentiary one
That's
day.
Right.
Running from the police.
That's right. Right.
Mama catch me, put a whooping to my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen. Mama, I finally understand for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did it, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
There you have it, my top 5 hip-hop tracks about mama. Now, we got a little controversy. Somebody said that my man T from Huntsville called up and said, I miss Goody Mob's Guess Who. And if that's the case, I apologize. I'm definitely going to listen to it after this show and see if I did miss it. But there goes my list. Number 5 was Jay-Z, Mama Loves Me. Number 4, Brand Nubian, Mama. A lot of the young people don't even know who the hell Brand Nubian is. We got a couple of groups we got to play tribute to on Tuesday, on a tribute Tuesday. Number 3, Kanye West, Hey Mama. Number 2, Ghostface Killah, All That I Got Is You. And coming in at number 1 on the list is the great Tupac Shakur, Dear Mama. Yes, sir. Miami Dolphins rookie first-round draft pick Laremy Tunsil's attorneys and agents are investigating his relationship with a former business manager, financial advisor, and trying to determine what role, if any, the man might have played in accessing Tunsil's Twitter and Instagram accounts during last week's NFL draft. Based on what Tunsil's representatives uncover, they might turn their findings over to the FBI. Basically, this guy, they're determined that he's a runner, not an actual agent like Laremy Tunsil thought that he was. So when Tunsil found out that the guy actually wasn't a certified agent and that he was just a go-between, it was kind of too late. He had built this relationship with him. The guy in question bought Laremy Tunsil a cell phone back in October as a gift. And you know how it is. When you download an app and you put in your passwords and all of that stuff, it kind of stays on the phone. A lot of times, you know, it's like save the password. And so you can log out of it or you can get out of the app, but, you know, your passwords and your usernames are still in it. So it sounds like that the mystery is solved to me. They got this dude, so they're still doing an investigation. They're saying that Laremy Tunsil, you know, lost at least $7 million and as high as $10 million. No, I'm not going to just let this die. These cats in the Puppet Factory this morning, Mike Golick was saying how, you know, that they would probably be best just to let it go and just move on. Hell no! Now, I don't know if this guy got the $7 million that Laremy Tunsil lost, but I'm going to go after it. I'm going to go after it. $7 million, $10 million is $7 million, $10 million, man. Hell no. And so I can't wait to find out. I thought that this hacker, you know, would never be found. But this guy isn't even a hacker. He's just a dude that somehow got back the information that from the phone. This is the story, allegedly. And, you know, put out this picture of Laremy Tunsil 13 minutes before the draft, dropping him from the first pick to the second offensive tackle taken, and in effect losing $7 to $10 million. Oh, hell no. I'm going to damn ride this to the damn wheels come off. We'll take this. Ooh, I almost cussed just now. We'll take this ish all the way to the Supreme Court. And yeah, dude probably don't have the money, but it's the principle of the matter. And also, man, the Florida State Seminoles, the student government at Florida State passed an ordinance that restricts fans from wearing Native American headdresses at school sporting events. That's right. The ordinance states that the Student Senate doesn't condone the wearing of the headdresses because it inaccurately depicts the culture of the Seminole tribe. Traditional Seminole tribe headgear is a more of a turban style and not the long, exaggerated, feathered headdresses that we've seen in cartoons and TV all these years that are usually seen at FSU sporting events. Did y'all know that? Yeah, so they've got a picture of it. It looks kind of like, once again, kind of like a turban type thing that you'll see a lot of the African tribes wearing on pictures, you know, from back in the day. It's more of that than just, you know, the feathers that are poking up from a little headband or whatever. No. So in a way, it's disrespectful. And it goes back to the conversation about, you know, are they really paying homage to Native Americans or are they mocking them? You know, and I contend they're mocking them. At a time where all these Native American mascots came along, man, and they were frowned upon. They were looked down upon. That's what you got to go back to the root of this. You can't just look at it over the last couple of years and take somebody's word for it. Oh, we're paying homage to Native Americans. No! When the Washington Redskins came out with their mascot logo, it wasn't to pay homage. It was just blatant mocking of Native Americans. So stop it. And so this is just the first step. And I'm sure in 10 years, all of these Native American mascots and signs and logos are going to be gone. A lot of the teams have already moved away from them. And it's just right. Not all Native Americans probably feel offended by them. But I'm sure there's a lot of them that are on record. And if it's offensive to them, who are you to say that it's not offensive? It's just stupid to me. It's just very, very stupid. And there are a lot of Native Americans on record saying that they feel offended by this. You know? There are a lot. How would you like it if they had a team called the Kansas City Blackies? You know? If you were black and they had a team called the Kansas City Blackies, it's the same equivalent to the Washington Redskins. I don't understand why it's so hard to understand. So, I mean, I guess that's a first step, but it's going to get much bigger. The ish is going to hit the fan for the Cleveland Indians, for the Florida State Seminoles. It's going to hit the fan for all of them. And trust me, in 10 years, all of them will have made a change, kind of like the Syracuse Orange men, now the Syracuse Orange, or even the college that I played, you know, football for in my freshman year, the Newberry Indians. They changed their name to the Newberry. I think they're Wolves or something like that right now. It's just progress, man. Come on. Let's be better. Just stop it. Yeah. From Rel Scott in the chat room on Spreaker.com, he says, colonizers mocking someone. No, get out of here. Yeah, man. I mean, come on, man. You know what it is. I mean, you know what it is. You know what it is! We're not mocking them. Daniel Snyder is dumbass. And I mean, he is fighting this thing. And yeah, a lot of it has to do with money, I'm sure, in Washington and trademarks and their brand and whatever. Man, get you a new brand. Get you a new logo, a new trademark. You will sell a ton of paraphernalia, a ton of licensed product if the Washington football organization comes out with a new logo, maybe new colors and everything. That's a merchandising bonanza. Stop it. Like, it's personal with Daniel Snyder and this damn mascot. Really, bruh? Really? I bet he's casting a vote for Donald Trump's ass, too. Hey, man. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Doug Stewart Show. Thank you. I can't thank you enough. Shouts out to my man Waterhead, Walter, Dwayne, Vasan, Gerald, Oliveri, producers and engineers for the Doug Stewart Show. Thank you. Big ups to my man Pink Gator. Him and Beans and Cornbread on this hot ass track. Yes, sir. And a thank you to all of the Stewies, all of the new listeners that we had that turned into the show today, man. And tuned into the show today. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you. Yes. All right. Coming up in about 5 minutes, the Kicking It with Kesey show. The title of today's episode is Stop Effing Posting Everything on Social Media, Man. Yeah. So Kesey, as always, man, very interesting conversation and talking about social media and how our kids are just out of control with it, man. Stay tuned to that. And then at 1 p.m. right here on SME, The Grizz, my man Rashad Grismore, South Central LA's finest. And at 2 p.m. today, the Bottom to the Top show, the return of John Fisher cooking with the microwave. He had to go out of town for a couple of days. He's back. Him and the number one chief rocker, Vern from Jersey. As well as, I forgot about this. My man John Fisher's grandmama, Miss Eunice, is going to pay him a visit today on the show. Grandma and Eunice today on the Bottom to the Top show. Stay tuned for that. All right, we'll do this show again tomorrow. Same Doug Stewart time, same Doug Stewart channel. Peace. Listen to SME.